Hi there. In this tip, we're going to take a quick look at how you can create some cool effects using the collision deformer. We start off by creating a collision deformer. It's here in the deformers menu, and it's been here ever since R13, I believe. So you'll need at least Cinema 4D R13 to do this tutorial. The way the collision deformer works is that it deforms whatever object is in its hierarchy. So the simplest way to use it is to place collision deformer as a child of another object, or place it as a sibling in a null object or something like that. So now that the collision deformer is in the plane, nothing actually happens yet. We need to say, okay, which objects are going to collide with this plane in order to deform it. So there's a colliders menu here. So we can take our cube and drag our cube into colliders, and then you get that sort of an effect. Now, at first, it doesn't look great because we have some tweaking to do. Let's just see what's happening on a frame-by-frame basis. It looks like it's starting to deform the object. It's doing that really well. And then if we go one frame at a time, the minute it hits the midpoint, it sort of changes its mind and starts to deform upwards instead. So as it deforms upwards, we see that the solver essentially flips on itself and says, okay, let's obviously the cube is coming from beneath. So this is kind of a glitch, but I think we can use that to our advantage. So if we play it back one more time, we can see how it happens. And we can essentially say to ourselves, all right, we want to improve this effect. The first thing we can do is go to the Advanced tab and change the stiffness. A lower stiffness will sort of make it easier for the object to make a dent in the object that's being deformed. So that's one thing we can do. Another thing we can do is go to the Object tab and tweak the Restore Shape option. So if we change Restore Shape down to 0, we'll see what happens. It just stretches right through. So that's not really the effect we want, but it gives us an idea of what we can tweak. So if this was 40% instead, we see that it sort of is less of an aggressive rebound. It goes through and then it pops right back out, but it doesn't happen instantaneously. It takes a second. You can see it stretch right here below. So another really cool thing that you can do to make this pairing sort of interesting is change the fall off. So currently the fall off is automatically calculated. I've just paused it as it's entering the material. What we can do is go to the Collision Deformers Object tab and change the falloff. These options here are what the falloff curve is going to be relative to. So think of UV, distance, surface, and collider almost like additional solvers. These are additional methods that the collision deformer is going to look at when applying our spline. So just for speed's sake, I'm going to set it to distance. Now, keep an eye on the way it's deforming as I change this. So if I put this part of the curve up high, it does create some jagged edges, some sharp transitions, but it actually makes a bulge. I'm going to play it back right here so we can see that bulge. It's actually bulging up into the object as it falls through. Now, that's kind of cool because some gooey substances may give the impression that they behave that way. So if we put this back down to 0 where it belongs, and then create more points by holding down Control, we can create a hump up like that, and then sort of a valley down here. So we can create sort of a valley like that. So now if we play it back, we get a really interesting effect. It's almost like it's going down and up at the same time. And if we let it play back, we get an interesting sort of blob. So what we can do is make that a little bit less extreme, add some more points to make sort of a diminishing wave, and we can see that we're creating sort of an interesting entry point. And we can make it look a little bit different by changing the fall off from distance to surface. You see how it sort of changed the way that it behaved? And then we can also choose Collider. So Collider is the slowest according to the documentation, but you can see that it's the most accurate. It really starts to slow down when you use Collider, but it gives a really cool effect. Now, we can tweak the effect further by going back to the Advanced tab and changing these. For instance, the effect with a very low stiffness sort of changes. It becomes sharper. With a very high stiffness, it becomes more rubbery. So, there should be some interesting effects you guys can make using this, but I just wanted to call attention to the curve property here for the collision deformer, because it provides some really cool opportunities for tweaking what the collision actually looks like. And it actually takes the shape of the cube. You know, so if I were to rotate the cube so it hits the surface at a different angle, the entire effect gets changed. It's going really slowly right about now. So let's try changing that fall off method to surface and see if it runs a little more quickly. Yeah, there you go. But it completely changes the shape that we're dealing with. And I hope you guys enjoyed that tip. Until next time, see ya.